First of all, you need to enable the beta feature for material variants. This gets asked to me frequently. If you can't find the feature in the list, then it means it's not in beta anymore. So you can skip this part. Also, search for material service in Explorer. If you have it without doing this part, just skip this part. What you need to search for here is the one called material service. Tick the box near it to enable the feature, then save and restart Studio. Material service is a way of adding custom materials to parts. If you try to put a surface apperance object to a part, you'll get the warning which says it's only for mesh parts. Material service makes it easy to also enable custom materials for standard parts. You'll still need the assets you need for PBR, so let's also look at some websites to get some free PBR textures. This is one of the two sites I will link to description. This site is called Polyhaven, and it has a lot of custom materials available for various textures, and also for free. It has a limited amount of material count in some categories, like metal, so I will link another website to description, which is also really good. When you are downloading one of them, make sure to select 1K on resolution, because you won't be able to upload most of higher resolution assets to Roblox. After you select the resolution, you can download the asset. It'll come in a zip format which you'll need to extract. You can of course download assets from other websites as well, but if you download one from this site, these files are the ones you'll get. Most of these have the proper names for their functionalities, but this normal map is on a different format. I used Adobe Photoshop to convert this to a PNG, but you can use any trusted converter as well. This is one of the drawbacks of this website, so make sure to check out the second site from description as well. After you create a material variant in material service, you can fill these properties with the files you got. You don't need to use all of these if your texture pack doesn't have them. There's also this base material value which I couldn't see really useful if you won't override default materials. After creating your material variant, you can select your part and set its material variant property to the one you created. There's the material I created. One of the biggest differences of this new feature with surface apparences is the behavior when you are resizing the part. It doesn't stretch like an image and it actually repeats along the part surface. There are some configurations for these material variants. You can change the material pattern and studs per tile. You should try experimenting with these values to see how they change the look of your material. I'll go ahead and add more materials here so we can compare them side by side. Here, I have two more materials and also a mesh part under all of them, so we can compare them with surface apparences. Top ones are parts and bottom ones are meshes with surface apparence. These two are not the same things, however it's still good to see them side by side. First difference is the studs per tile property. Surface apparence just stretches with surface, but material variants can be tweaked for best look. If you scale them, they'll also keep their texture look. One thing I see here is surface apparence shows more accurate colors than material variants. I wonder if it's something to do with base materials, however I couldn't spot a difference. This granite here is my favorite so far. This one was downloaded from the second site which will be in description. You can see the distortion and the reflection of sun, that's a material feature. Here, if I change the base material, we currently need to set the material variant property again. That'll probably get fixed later, but you should decide on these values before setting them to your parts. There's one more thing to look at, and that's this material manager. You can see all materials in your game with this, including the ones you added manually. You can also add new materials with this button. It's basically what we did with properties, but I recommend using this because it's simply better visualized. There's also a button here to apply the material to selected parts, and also for showing the selected material on Explorer. You have this icon near your custom material variants. You can distinguish the ones you added. You can also set your custom materials as override. This will override the selected base material with your custom material. Overall, I think this is a great addition, and will make visuals a lot better than before. That was it for this video. Hope you understood. See you in another one.